If Miss Stick tells you it's 10 degrees Celsius outside, you'll make sure to grab a jacket, and you wouldn't have needed any additional information in making that decision. What if Miss Stick told you she hid your Xbox 1 kilometer from the house? What then? Well, unless you're willing to search every spot 1 kilometer in all directions, which I'm sure you're willing to do, you're going to need more information. Specifically, the direction. 1 kilometer north from the house, for example. As you can see, some physical quantities such as temperature only require that you provide its magnitude, which can be represented with a single number. Others require that you provide not only magnitude but direction as well. The most common example of the latter is displacement, which is a fancy word for moving from one point to another. If a physical quantity only indicates the magnitude, it's called a scalar quantity. If it also has a directional quality to it, it's called a vector quantity. In order to avoid confusion, when you write vectors, you'll have to place a line or arrow above it. We like to use an arrow because it reminds everyone of its directional quality. But if you want to isolate and indicate only the magnitude portion of a vector, putting vertical bars on both sides will do the trick. Remember though, the magnitude of a vector is a scalar quantity and is always positive. It's also important to remember that two vectors are the same if they have the same magnitude and direction, regardless of where they're located in space. In other words, vectors are the same regardless of where you start. So moving 1 kilometer north from your house is the same as moving 1 kilometer north from Miss Stick's house. Hence, we indicate both displacements as vector A. On the other hand, a displacement with the same magnitude but with an opposite direction can conveniently be represented as negative A. It goes without saying that A is not equal to negative A. Also, a displacement is always a straight line. So it doesn't matter whether you took the scenic route to your Xbox or went right after it. You might have traveled a longer distance with the scenic route, but the displacement is still the same and can both be represented as vector A. The directional information in vectors are extremely important, and whether you realize it or not, is utilized to engineer the cars you drive and develop the games you play on your Xbox. So stay tuned and we'll show you how to add them. Stick Science.